Let's go to RabbitMQ and create the queue for this lecture. Create course.employee queue. In Java, we use Java 10. Let's adjust our source code compatibility to Java 10 so we can use some of its features. Open build.gradle on RabbitMQ producer and then change source compatibility to Java 1.10. Then let's import required libraries. Copy the library syntax from lecture 21. Our Spring Boot uses Gradle as library dependency manager, so we have to paste the text into Gradle configuration file. On RabbitMQ producer, open the file build.gradle and then paste the text on section dependencies. Save the file and Gradle will download required libraries. This happens automatically because we select automatic synchronization when we create RabbitMQ producer project. In case your library import does not happen automatically, refresh manually by right-clicking on RabbitMQ Producer Project, select Gradle, and refresh Gradle Project. Now that we have JSON dependencies imported, let's create a new class to be serialized as JSON. Create a new package called entity under com.course.rabbitmqproducer. Create employee class within entity package. We need three attributes: string employee ID, string name, and date birth date. Use java.util.date for date class. You can do this by selecting during control space or right-clicking and choose Source Organize Imports. Create public getters and setters for employee by right-clicking employee.java and choose source and choose generate getters and setters. Next, let's create constructor with all fields as parameters. Right-click on employee.java and choose source, generate constructor using fields, select all fields, and then click generate. Eclipse will automatically generate constructor for us. It's always a good practice to format source code and sorting members to improve source code readability. Let's do so with right click, choose source, and format. You can use Ctrl+Shift+F2 for shortcut. And sort members by right-clicking again, choose source, sort members. Now let's publish dummy employee. On package producer, create new class. Employee JSON producer. Mark the class as service and auto-wire RabbitMQ template. Create method sendMessage with parameter employee to send. To convert Java class to JSON, we will use JSON object mapper. So let's create a field with type object mapper and create new instance. We don't need to use autoWire annotation for object mapper, just keyword new. I will not going too deep on Spring, but in case you little confused, using autoWire on Rabbit template will create Rabbit template with Spring dependency injection. So if you configure your RabbitMQ differently, like the one in lecture 17, Spring Boot will take values from application.properties and inject values to correct pin. In this case, Rabbit template. Object mapper, on the other hand, does not need any dependency injection. So, create instance with new is enough. To convert Java object to JSON string, we can use object mapper.writeValue as string. Now we can send this JSON string to queue course.employee. Let's run employee JSON producer. Modify the main application on RabbitMQ producer application.java. I'll remove the codes for Hello Rabbit. And disable scheduling for fixed rates producer. Next, autoWire an employee JSON producer. Create some dummy employees and send it to RabbitMQ. Here, I create 5 dummy employees and send each of them to queue. Let's run the producer and check RabbitMQ. Let's check course.employee queue. It should contain 5 employees. Let's purge it for now.